Hi, I just wanted to check in and touch base with you about a lot of the concepts that we're covering here in small business management and entrepreneurship, and also continue our dialogue about exactly what we're looking for in this class, not just your desire to be an entrepreneur, but really how we do an analysis of an entrepreneurial opportunity and see if it's really going to generate enough income to make it worthwhile. So I'm over here in the Niemeyer Center here at Clackamas Community College over in our theater and arts department, and I thought this would be a good place to shoot this a short video for us to talk about the concepts, because we have a gallery here where artists display their work. It's one platform for them to get some sales or to get some PR about their work. And so I thought maybe we'd step inside and then I could use an artist as an example of an entrepreneur and the small business management and entrepreneurship issues that they run into. So let's walk inside and take a look. So I really like this artist's work. Obviously, she has a lot of talent, and doing artwork is a perfect example of an entrepreneur trying to create an opportunity to have a real work-life balance by producing the products yourself and then getting them sold and producing you a nice income. I like this particular piece of artwork because it's a good analogy for the small business management that we face when we're an entrepreneur, even as an artist. Oftentimes I use a hat rack, and then I point out that you have to wear very many hats when you're a small business owner. And so since we don't have a hat rack, this is kind of the next best thing, because it does represent a lot of chaos in the amount of business management you have to do. Oh, and by the way, in the gallery, my voice is gonna echo a little bit, so sorry about that. But as you can see, I think the gallery is a pretty cool setting, especially for us looking at entrepreneurial type stuff. The different types of hats or wooden spoons, if you will, that you'd be using as a small business manager is obviously you're the person who has to set up the business organization, decide are you gonna be a sole proprietor, what's gonna be the name of your business, are you gonna legally register with the IRS and be claiming your income, and how's that income gonna come in, and are you gonna be prepared to take taxes out of it, are you gonna be doing the bookkeeping for that income? Are you going to be monitoring your expenses? Are you then going to be the one who meets with the accountant and does all of that? What about the marketing? For an artist, for example, they have to find different galleries to show their work. They have to hope to get into catalogs. They have to maybe build their own website. Are you going to be the website manager? Are you going to be the one taking pictures of your artwork and placing them on there? Are you going to be the one responsible for driving traffic to your website? How are you going to sell things? That's always a big thing for small business management and entrepreneurship. So we start looking at all the various responsibilities that you have. The thing I like about using an artist as an example is that we'll have a little better idea of what the cost is to create the products. Oftentimes it's just their hourly work to create something, but there is some cost of some materials that they would use. In your types of businesses or in a gig type business, then one might have to calculate how much it costs for you to get that product. For example, in the student sample that you looked at last week, it was about resale, so that entrepreneur has to invest money into inventory before they even sell it, whereas an artist or a musician or somebody, an actor, doesn't necessarily have to create anything, but they still have to find a bridge to sales which is a way to drive traffic to whatever it is you're trying to sell, and then complete those sales. And I think that becomes one of the hardest hats to wear, certainly as an artist, because it's hard to really get in the perfect place where the right demographic's gonna see it and love your work and then buy it. Okay, so at this point in the class, what we're beginning to do is shift to a two-prong analysis of businesses. One prong is with respect to the small business management, and the second prong is with respect to generating revenue or creating some kind of revenue-generating model that will show how much in sales you need to make in order to achieve your desired income. So I had you look at the student sample last week, sorry for the elementary questions, but because I just wanted you to see an example of what you're going to be preparing for your final project here, which is that feasibility analysis. So the next step for you in the project is going to be choosing your idea, but I really want you to be thinking about the effort that you need to put into the business management side of it. So when we are looking at the organization of the business in that section, there's more to it. As we've been talking about here with an artist, for example, in creating a brand for the artist's name, in creating contractual relationships with galleries and places to place your art and sell your art, by creating marketing tools such as a website, maybe a vlog in order to drive traffic to your artwork and sell it, that they're the ones at the end of the day that have to do the bookkeeping and the overall management and the organization and everything. And it can be exhausting, but extremely rewarding. But we want to take that overall analysis, look at the business management, and not just a look at whether something can succeed when it comes to profit. So that was it. I just wanted to check in with you at this point to let you know that you are doing great work. If you have any questions about the work to be submitted, just email me or try to come during my office hours on Monday and Wednesday from 1 to 3 in Streeter Hall 128. Otherwise, just keep up the great work, and I'll be doing another video for you after the midterm to check in again and talk a little bit more about the final product of the feasibility analysis. So that's it for now. Thanks.